Good morning and welcome to this Wednesday's devotion. Thank you so much for joining us today. Today I want to confess something to you. I am a forgetful person. Some people just aren't forgetful, but I'm actually really forgetful. And for those of you who know me, you will know that I so often forget. I forget where I've left my car keys. I forget where I've left my phone. And now that I have to use glasses to read, I often forget where I've left my glasses. And you know, I have even found myself going to Belfast for a day's shopping and at the end of the evening coming back to the car park and forgetting where I've parked the car. It's really not good. But today I don't want to talk to you about our natural memories. I want to talk to you about our spiritual memories. Today I want to say to you, don't forget to remember. Don't forget to remember. King David talks about this in Psalm 103, and this is what he says. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgives all your iniquities, who heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from destruction, and crowns you with loving kindness and tender mercies. What if you and I lived each day like this, remembering all God's benefits to us, that we are forgiven, that we don't need to live in shame and guilt because God promises that he's removed our sins as far as the east is from the west, that he remembers our sins no more, remembering that God is our healer, remembering the breakthroughs that God has given us in our lives. Calling the goodness of God to mind so that we can draw strength in these times. Forgetting makes us prey to the enemy. And there's a Bible story that's found in Numbers chapter 13. And God has asked Moses to gather some men and go and explore the land of Canaan, the promised land. And this is what it says in verse 2. From each tribe of their fathers, you shall send a man, every one a leader among them. I am giving the land to you. That line is key because what God is saying in that is, remember, I promised you the land. I'm going to give the land to you. So 12 men in total go out to spy out the land. And as you read this chapter, you will see it isn't a mystery tour that they're going on. The 12 spies are given clear instructions where to go. They're to go to the Negev and they're to go to the hill country. And in verses 18 to 20, the spies are told what they're to find out. It says, see what the land is like, whether the people who dwell in it are strong, weak, few or many. Whether the land they dwell in, is it good? Or is it bad? Whether the cities they inhabit, are they unwalled or fortified? Whether the land is rich or poor? The spies are told to bring back some fruit of the land, and the mission actually took the spies 40 days to complete. And the 12 spies come back to bring their report back to the leaders, and this is where it all went wrong. What should have been simply a mission, gathering information for the next season, actually became a mission that gathered information that locked them out of their future. In verse 27, the spies all agree that the land truly flows with milk and honey, and it's fruit in it just as God had said. But then we read that 10 of the spies bring a bad report, focusing on the fact that the people who dwell in the land are strong, the cities are fortified and very large, that there's giants in the land, and the spies even describe themselves as grasshoppers. They let fear and unbelief keep them from entering everything that God has promised them, from living the life that God has intended for them to live. Don't allow fear and unbelief to keep you from the life that God has for you. See yourself as God sees you today. You are not a grasshopper. You are a child of the Most High God. God is bigger than any giant that you face today. And in contrast, Two of the spies, they were called Joshua and Caleb, and they bring back a good report. It's full of faith and confidence in God. And this is what it says in Numbers chapter 13, verse 30. Caleb speaks up and says, "Let us go up at once and take possession, for we are well able to overcome it. You and I, with God on our side, are well able to overcome the giants that we face today." You see, all 12 spies saw the same thing, but only two, Joshua and Caleb, saw it through the filter of remembering the God who had brought them out of Egypt, remembering the God who had parted the Red Sea, that they could walk through the Red Sea on dry ground, remembering the God who had provided manna for them every day along the way. Joshua and Caleb didn't allow the presence of giants to detract from the promises of God. I'm going to say that again. They didn't allow the presence of giants to detract from the promises of God. Today, you may be standing on promises and you haven't seen them fulfilled today and are yet happening in your life. But you know what? You may see giants in front of you in the way of the promise, but don't allow the giants to detract from the promise of God that is over your life today. Faith always gives a good report. Faith sees the victory. Faith doesn't minimize the circumstances, but it refuses to focus on them. It focuses on God. Our difficulties that we face at the moment are actually opportunities. They're opportunities for God to show himself strong on our behalf. And today, as you face giants, what you need to do is remember the promise. Promises that say, if you are facing sickness today, God is your healer. If you are facing financial difficulties today, that giant is looming above you. God is your provider. If you are facing anxiety today, God says, I promise you there is a peace that comes only from me, a peace that will pass all understanding, that will guard your hearts and minds. God says that today he's your sustainer. He will perfect that which concerns you. And Psalm 77 verse 11 says this, I will remember the deeds of the Lord. Yes, I will remember your miracles of long ago. I will consider all your works and meditate on all your mighty deeds. Today, call back to mind, remember the faithfulness of God, the goodness of God in your life. And we're going to add one more layer to this before I go. And we're going to fast forward 40 plus years from that mission. We're going to see now that Joshua is actually leading the people of Israel. And God has just performed a miracle that allows the people of Israel to walk through the River Jordan on dry land to the promised land. And God gives Joshua an instruction. And here's what he says, get 12 men, one man from each tribe. Does it sound familiar? And he tells them to go back to the River Jordan and that they are each to lift a stone from the riverbed and bring the 12 stones back. And it sounds like a strange thing to do. They've just crossed the River Jordan and God is saying to them, I want you to go back to the River Jordan. I want you to pick up stones and I want you to bring them back. And here's the reason why. And it's found in Joshua chapter 4, verse 6. This is what it says, that this may be a sign among you when your children ask in time to come. You see, the stones were a visual reminder of what God had done. Every time they walked past those stones with their children, they said to their children, that is a remembrance of God. He was faithful to his promises. He brought us through many victories. He was on our side. And you know, today we have got faith stones. And today you could take your faith stones. the things in your life that God has done for you. That might be prayers that he has answered for you. Perhaps he has healed you. Perhaps you have seen a financial breakthrough. Perhaps you have seen him move in your life and done wonderful works in your life. Promises that he has given you. Tell them to your children. Today, why don't you take some time with your children and tell them about your faith stones? Grandparents, tell your grandchildren about your faith stones. Allow your stones of faith to create stepping stones for your children and your grandchildren. Maybe you need to begin to journal today. Maybe you need to begin to journal and write down your stones of faith. Why don't you begin to do that today? Today, don't forget to remember God's faithfulness and his goodness to you. Have a good day remembering.